Hi, this is Luke Kahng. Thanks for watching my video. Today's topic is why my single crown did not match. From my 30-year experience, we all the time struggling regarding the color, single tooth match like that, okay? Everybody struggle, but there's a reason. This video, we're going to show you how can we match the single tooth perfectly. Stay tuned. Okay, let's talk about the problem. So number one, communication, like this. It's fuzzy, it's too bright, it's blurry, you cannot see clear definition. You have to take the good high definition regardless of what kind of camera, and then I need a shake tap number. If we do not communicate it correctly, and result is like this. Okay, one of these miscommunications is too far, you know what I mean? It's too far, I want a little bit more close. That is much better. Here's a miscommunication. I have no idea what they want. Please do not send me like this. If you really want to take the good communication with the patient, patient wear the nice lipsticks, you have to have them illuminate it or erase it because it's irritating their teeth. Patient must brush their teeth before you take the color. Make sense? Otherwise, when patient drinks Starbucks coffee, whole pot, guess what? The other side is all brown hue. So I'm using the brown hue. After I made it, delivered to the dentist office, it's not going to match it. My restoration is darker than the other side. Even though good photo, I like the crack line. I like the translucency, dull texture, but I do not have any shade tap. The problem is shade tap is even though you got the number, and then here's a pre-close, and then here's a match, it looks good. This one is fake restorations. So here's a big problem. We work with the Vera shade tab and 3D shade tab. It's not matching the natural Jason teeth enamel dentition at all. I would say only 5%. This is a high value, right? Now think about it, everybody wants natural teeth. You know what natural teeth mean? Medium value and kind of little less value. But fake teeth, straight tap, you get the high value. So whenever you set B1, I make the B1 for you. So my question to you, if you choose B1, you send it out to A, B, C different lab. So you prescribe B1, I want beautiful cosmetic, you send it out to 3 different labs. You get the same result from shade tab. That's completely fake restoration like that. This is great illustration. So I don't want to make the fake restoration. Like I mentioned earlier, everybody want a natural tooth crown. How? Do not follow shade tab. So here's the indications. Did not follow like this. Did not follow like this, okay? It is base color here, A2. But the other one is a BO. And then here's a calcification in order to match this one. Make sense? I'm talking about naturalism, okay? So it's not like the McDonald's cheeseburger. It's not like the 1+1, 2, it's not. How do I know? I made over 100 articles regarding single tooth shade matching. You can watch out my old previous article if you have a time. This is a good picture, which is I took it. And then I see really detailed color. At the same time, I write it down to my color's number. And then here is the high value, but I can see the same value I can check, except translucency and with the character. This is a fingerprint, which is God created us. You see the fingerprint? You cannot see in our eyes. But we can see with our macro camera, right? Number two, preparations. Mistake is the after they prepped it and then take the color. That's the problem because whenever they prep the teeth, it takes probably 10 or 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depends on the prep. And then after they prep it, think about it, they open it, and they give it an anesthesia, and then they trying to prep. The problem is, Jason teeth getting dehydrated, meaning there's no color to it. You see the more whitish color, because there's no saliva, there's no moisture. So what I'm saying is, whenever they took the prep and then take the color, usually not matching to the Jason teeth. It's a very important concept. So what should you do? You have to take the color before prep. See, especially this kind of like that, here's more darker than the other. Probably that's why. Look at the dehydrated teeth, getting more whitish, all right? So what they can do after they try with the crowns, and they close lips, have them get the saliva, and then wait about the 30 seconds, 1 minute to get moisture. You need a proper shade guide. I know everybody has this. This is a more popular with the Vera. This is a classic. This is 3D. So unfortunately, it's none of them matching the natural teeth. I'm telling you, only 5% matching. Only matching whoever has a fake restoration in the patient's mouth. So not only that, I can utilize with our shade tab, which is porcelain system, GC initial porcelain system. They have an own shade tab. It's a thin, about 1 millimeter. In how many colors are indicated, and then I can prescribe it to make the better coloring. Internal color will affect my final restoration when I have a lack of room. Especially this, same size facially. If I using the Lisi press or all ceramic restorations, you will see slightly here different than the other. So it will be color differentiations. So how can you solve? Easy. When you think it's a dark color and the prep a little bit more than the other, that was more helpful. This is Lisi press. This is for contour. Now, this is a detailed indication with the thickness. The thickness will change everything. So whenever you put the different coloring, like I said, you put the low value, a lot of enamel color, that you created that color exactly. So this much, we're fighting about 5/10, 7/10, 1 millimeter porcelain layer. You see, we're battling about 1 millimeter layer concept. You cannot build a thick, right? You cannot make the under contour. You have to make the proper contour in order to match Jason teeth. And then apply this, the porcelain layer. Look at this discoloration. So after they prep the teeth, will be color different. Guess what? You have to prep a little bit more than you think in order to match Jason teeth. Now we're talking about the material selection. We have to using the good materials, zirconium and lithium disilicate. And also we can make the only porcelain, right? But this one, you have to see what color inside will affect final aspect too. This is what I'm talking about, the black porcelain core. We need the communication. We need the color in order to make the all ceramic restorations. When we make the porcelain fused metal, which is I don't recommend it. This is a porcelain fused metal here. You see high value and the gum line is too gray? Like this. Okay, the other case is here, is all black porcelain core. This is really indicated in order to match Jason teeth. Why? This is natural teeth. Natural teeth has a medium value, has a lot of layer on it. So hard to match the other Jason teeth, I just admit that, okay? And not only that, I indicated about surface texture. So whenever you said vertical ridge, and then here is the horizontal line, you know the word vertical ridge meaning reflection. Whenever patient get the wet, and you can see the reflection. Whenever you see concave, you don't get any reflection. Now is material selection with the fluorescence. So high is good fluorescency, which is more natural, especially when patients go to nightclub with different light, and we see the same result. So that's we have to be careful about that. So I testing with the old porcelain, the baking, which is in a blue, clear, and the whitish color, we test it. That's the material selection. This is opaque, so we have to really care about that. And then you have to write it down, just like the custom shape chart we made it. What is this? Information, just like the patient chart. So whoever come down to my office, they write it down, their information. And not only that, we just side view and the frontal view. I just indicate the hue, value, chroma. And then if we 6 unit case, I indicate a little bit more detail along with the material selection after that. But I follow the A1 base, like I said, A1 base. Then I surrounded by everything chalky, translucency halo, I made this. So we call this a signature line, and this is pretty expensive cases, I'm telling you. It's not going to work with the insurance, because insurance, you got the $700, $500, whatever. And the laboratory only get the 10%, maybe less. You cannot get a $99 crown. You cannot get a $100 crown. You cannot get it. Here's my background. We took the custom color with all dental professionals long time ago. There was a guideline for this. And then we have a communication with the doctors long time ago. I miss those days. So this is the lab test, enamel testing. I see the graduation. You cannot see much, but I see a little gray, and then tan, and with the pink and whitish color, which is the enamel, before I apply, just like that. So I took it out, peel off, and like this. So lay down, indicate together, and then you can see the different color from blue, white, and then white, and then clear, and then tan, you can see different color. So that's why I created the naturalism. So this is one of the key to make the success. So this is very important, like I said, the gold porcelain core, and we have to know the proper material selection, then we match the adjacent teeth, like this. Okay? The single tooth, this is the most toughest color to match in the world. Let me tell you, I'm being honest with you. This is a mamelon, just like cloud. You know the cloud meaning? It disappears, sometimes there, sometimes gone, sometimes later. But here's more problem. The mamelon I call the disappear cloud with color cloud. Meaning whenever I see the light tan, but after I dehydrate, this is changed suddenly. This is a gas creation. Along with a little opalescency, and then with the halo, and the tan here surrounded by, this is crazy. Whenever I got this case, probably I have to spend about 8, 10, 12, 14 hours easily, the one single crown. This just like that. Slightly different, but this is the best I can do. Here is my passion, trying to mimic the natural teeth as close as possible. I narrowed down 80 porcelain, and then I fabricated. And then I put the number. You have to make the good proper contour shape. You need the thickness, and then you can apply the porcelain recipe. Anyway, so this is my effort, which is I indicated is a dark and light. This, like I said, this is change everything, especially the veneers. The color testing with the different patients, this is our, you know, translucency. You know, the color, I tested with my own ceramic shade tab, with the discoloration, with the coloring. So here's a shade tab, so I indicated. So that's why I can fabricate like this. Now, I'm going to conclude it first. Like I said, I'm 30 year experience. I dedicate my life. I know what I'm doing. I admit for you, it's almost impossible rematching the natural teeth. And don't give up, try best you can, and then you get the final result. And this is part one. See you part two. Thank you very much.